Hello. In this video, we'll talk about basic group administration in Google Apps. We'll cover logging onto the admin console, adding groups, adding and removing users from those groups, group permissions, renaming groups, how to email a group, and how to delete a group. Okay, so let's get started. We've navigated to the URL for the admin console, which is admin.google.com. It's presented us with this screen yet again. We've selected the user account we want to log in as, and we've typed in the password. In our admin console. For this module, we're primarily concerned with groups. As you can see, we have the group icon here. Or we can access it, as we saw in other modules, via the left-hand side. So here we are in the group section. As you can see, there are some groups here that I've created when I went through the Google training. And we're going to start off straight away, I think, with creating our own group. I'm going to click the focus point at the bottom. We'll call the group Flower Delivery with an email address of flower, a small description, and you'll notice the access level. Now there are four of these: public, anyone can join, post messages, view members list and read the archives. Probably not a good idea in a corporate. Team, which I think has got a lot more use. Whereas managers can invite new members, but anyone can post messages, so anyone can contact the team, view the members, and read the archives. Announcement only, probably useful for just company-wide announcements. Only managers can post messages to a group and view the member list, but anyone in that organization can then join and read the archives. And then restricted, only managers can invite new members for R&D, for example, labs, manager lists, that sort of thing where things are meant to be left confidential. We're going to select team. The next section here is also allow anyone on the internet to post messages. We're not going to select this. And then you also have the option of adding everybody within that organization to this group. We're not going to select that either. We're just going to create our group. Okay, so our group's been created. As you can see at the top, you have the option to delete a group, add users to a group, or change the group info. Here we're allowed to change the email address should we want to, or the description, or even the group name. Adding users gives us a quick add. We can say myself as an owner, an add. Or we can add. Click on this section and we enter the full fat version, so to speak, of adding users, where we can type in Samantha Morse, our friend Tim, etc., and add them in as either owners or members. We don't want to add all users in our domain. So we're going to click add. And here are our members of our group. Let's go back to the root of the groups. We can see our flower delivery group. The type is team. for access, and there's the email address. Let's manage some people in this group. So we've decided that Tim Lee does not need to be in this group. We simply remove him. Easy as that. Okay, so let's add some more people into our group of flower delivery. We'll click on manage users in flower delivery. Start typing in our users. Ellie Gray and Tim, and one more, Lars, and we'll add them in as members. Okay, so we have a fully populated list of people in the flower delivery group. Let's go back to the home page of the admin console. Okay, so now we've got a fully populated group with an email address assigned to it. Let's go into the groups, into our group flower delivery, so we can see we've got the email address here as well. Click on that. Again, email address is listed at the top. We can add users as we previously mentioned, or change the group info. So we're going to go into and have a look, manage the users. Here's our list of users, okay, all five of them. And what we're going to do is we're going to send these people an email. So we're going to go into a Gmail client. Here we are, it's a Gmail client. And we're going to compose an email. And we're going to send a mail to the flower delivery group. And we're going to say a subject of testing, 1, 2, 3. And then we'll write a little block of text, testing 1, 2, 3. Picture of me in it, send, and away we go. So from sending that from any email client, the idea of it emailing to that group will be the same sort of thing as emailing to a distribution list. All members in that group will get a copy of that email. So if we go back in now to the admin console, and then to see as a group member what's happened, we can go into the group service. Okay, and here we go, we've got an email. We've got two emails. Here we go, testing 1, 2, 3. And there's the email we just sent, which is fantastic. And also we can then post a reply. We can reply to the person from the group as well. Reply by me. We'll CC in the flower, let the Wookiee lose people, so everyone will get CC'd in on it. Though you don't have to, you can click that off, and then only an individual from the team will reply, as opposed to everybody getting a copy of an email chain. And let's say response, let's beef that up a bit, red, let's put some huge letters in and post that. Now this might take a bit of time to go from A to B, we'll see. So let's go back now to the top of the groups page. What you can see here as well is that as a group, we can add a standard welcome message. So let's add something in. Welcome to the C&D Cakes flower delivery team. We can use all the standard methods of increase in text and manipulate in text, and we can save that as well. At the top of our screen, we've got our welcome message. Okay, so you can also clear that and edit that welcome message as well. Okay, so we've set our welcome message on our team page. We can see we've got some emails there, but we can also add topics. For example, let's start a new topic, and we can display this at the top and lock it. So like for an information comment, who is this guy emailing the team? Beware. Put the picture in. Warning. Just beef that text up. Bit of red for a bit of peril. Let's get some huge text in there. Let's get that centered and that centered. And then what we can do then, we can then post that. And you'll notice it'll appear at the top. So one thing I've noticed when going through this section of groups is that when you respond to an email that's been sent to you, and we did a quick response, if you recall, it does take its time in being sent out and routed to the recipient. We did a test yesterday on this and it worked. It was there this morning. So, you know, all we can assume is it will take a bit of time to have a response from a group. So back in our group, flower at letthewookieloose.co.uk, in the advanced group settings, it's very easy to remove people from the group, as we mentioned in a previous section, remove members. You can also set particular members as the owner. So I'm actually the owner, but let's have our boss as an owner. There you go. We've set that person to an owner and you see it's changed straight away. Let's go back to the original group settings. Here we go. And we could also delete a group. Now, here's our group sales. We've got no users in the group. We can just click on delete here and it's gone. We can click on the manage the sales group. And we click delete group there. And then it's gone. Are you sure you want to delete this group? Members will no longer have access to documents and other objects shared within the group. Deleting a group cannot be undone. Yes, delete this group. Bang, gone. Okay, so there you go. That is deleting a group. Okay, so thank you very much for watching this section on basic and very basic group management here in Google Apps. Please keep an eye out for our other episodes in the series. Thanks very much for watching.